Keep watching as we take this time to thank our sponsors, Roselle Mutual Insurance, McFarland Clinic, and Mackey Motors.
On a chilly Friday night, the Knights of Kuemper Catholic look to get back on track in district play. Kuemper had the size advantage over the Tigers from Red Oak, and they took advantage of that mismatch all night long. On the night's first drive, a lucky break for quarterback Cole Collison found the red and yellow up early.
Got some running room. He's got the edge. He's down to the 10, inside the 10, cuts it back in, breaks a tackle, fighting for it, loses the football. It's in the end zone. Did Kuemper fall on it? There's a touchdown. Coming up with the football was Jake Hugeback, and the Knights are on the board.
With the Red Oak offense struggling, the Knights struck fast again, putting another 7 up on the board.
Second down in goal to go, pistol formation this time. They'll turn, hand it off to Berg. Berg going to go forward and untouched into the end zone for a 2-yard touchdown run, and the Kuemper Knights have extended it to 13-0 with 10:37 remaining here in the first half.
Cole Collison was very efficient all night long, but it was Ben Berg capping off Kemper's third scoring drive.
Benoit turns, hands it, gives it off to Berg, and Berg fights his way into the end zone for the touchdown. Another 2-yard touchdown run that time from Berg.
The weather wasn't affecting the Knights' defense at all, as Blaze Gunderson and company were swarming all night long, causing turnovers and wreaking havoc.
He'll drop back, pressure comes, Gunderson runs right through a blocker, ball is hung up in the air, and Kenobi going to come up with the interception down at the 17-yard line.
Yeah, I think you can give credit to Blaze on that interception. He literally ran right through that running back that was trying to block him.
They're going to throw one behind the line of scrimmage, and Maine's hit and wrapped up. And the ball is loose, and it's going to be recovered by Kuemper. Is that Wanniger that come up with it? And Blaze Gunderson creating the turnover, and the Knights going to get the football back in really good field position.
Ben Berg would score on another short yardage run, making the score 28-0 late in the first half. But the Knights weren't done putting up points.
Collison going to keep it, and he'll go in easy for the touchdown. Offensive line had pushed everybody into the end zone, so Collison, a 1-yard touchdown run, and the Kuemper Knights are an extra point away from making this a 35-0 game here.
With a running clock throughout the second half, it was a struggle to get anything going. The tight end Blaze Gunderson would find the end zone one more time, capping off a successful Friday night for the Kuemper Knights.
Collison looking to throw it. He's got some time, now throws, and it is complete to Gunderson for a 5-yard touchdown.
Cole Collison earned Motor End Player of the Game honors, rushing for over 150 yards and 2 touchdowns, while also being very efficient with his arm. Thank you for watching this week's Roselle Mutual Game of the Week. Stay tuned after these ads to find out where we'll be next week.
Keep watching as we take this time to thank our sponsors, Roselle Mutual Insurance, McFarland Clinic, and Mackey Motors.
Next week, we're going to be featuring the Coon Rapids Baird Crusaders as they head to Oneida to face off against the Cougars of Cam. The Crusaders are looking to keep their playoff hopes alive, but they will need this big road win to do so.